thank you, everyone. So for those that don't know me, I'm a public speaking coach at Freedom Works UK. I'm really passionate about helping people find their voice and discover their passion for public speaking, and do that through long-term and structured coaching programs, short workshops, and also standalone sessions. And what I really want to do with my 10 minutes today is run a sort of interactive session with you, aimed so that you get to have a bit of a breakthrough in your public speaking, but also to give you a bit of a taster for how we work in a group setting, which will give you a little bit of an insight into how we work with Freedom Works. So this is going to be a little bit tricky while you're eating breakfast, but we're going to try and make it work. So this is a really great exercise that I do always when I do an introduction to public speaking. It's a really great way to have a breakthrough in your self-expression, but also to discover things about who you're being in the moment when you deliver your speeches and presentations. And it's a really useful way to start to enact a more powerful and inspiring way of being in your presentations and public speaking. And also for our work, we do a lot of work with acting and role play. Acting is a great way to discover your self-expression, to free you up, but also find things to work on in your presentations and public speaking. So I have a handout I'm going to hand out, and before I do that, what I'd like you to do is think of a situation where you're currently stopped in either public speaking, presentation, or pitching, or think about the types of people, the types of audiences that you struggle with, where you think perhaps you're not performing as well as you could. So have a think about that. I'm going to hand out this exercise. So if you could pass that one that way, and this one. And you also need a pen to do this. So we've got going around some very famous lines. And what I'd like to do is, you should see you've got two columns on the top, on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. What I'd like you to do is on the left-hand side, underneath the guy that's being fried to death in a frying pan, is write down a few of the words that come to mind when you think about that situation you're frying. So it could be being nervous, could be being anxious, worried about how you're coming across, kind of just getting through it, surviving the situation. But have a think about who you're being in that situation. So the audience that you struggle to be with,
yeah.
How do you feel? And then also think about some of the behaviours. So what actions are you taking to kind of get through that speech or presentation? And just jot down a few of the words that come to mind. A really useful way of doing this is thinking about if you were, if you had to kind of write a script and give your character to someone else to act out, how would you describe your character when you're in front of an audience that you're struggling to be with? So just jot down a few words. So would anyone just like to kind of share briefly what they've written down on the left-hand side?
Yeah.
Worried about what the audience is thinking.
Worried what the audience is thinking.
Where you don't want to be.
Where you don't want to be. Right. Okay, so just a few examples. So what I'd like to do is now shift to the right-hand side underneath King George the Sixth in the film. We've got the name of the film.
King's Speech.
King's Speech. What I'd like to do is think about an inspiring way of being that you could perhaps take on in that situation. So it could be being confident, it could be being inspiring. Write down a few words that come to mind when you think about how you would like to be in front of that audience. So it could be charismatic, daring, inspiring. If you didn't have to worry about how you were coming across, who would you like to be in that situation? People just started to share briefly what they've written down.
Okay.
Yeah,
good. Engaging.
Great, so being engaging, great.
Well informed.
I've written like Barack Obama.
Great, so and then what attributes, qualities, how would you describe that?
Confident, intelligent.
Confident, intelligent, great, perfect.
Statesman.
Statesman, great. 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 Okay, so what we're going to do now is give you a chance to kind of practice acting out those two different ways of being, so you can see who you're being when you get stopped and stuck in that situation, versus actually a really inspiring way of being you can take on in that moment. So what I'm going to do is just give you a demonstration, first of all, with a volunteer. So perhaps Joseph, if you'd like to just come to our back.
I'm still practicing.
So you don't need to do it, you just need to kind of stand there. And I'll do a demonstration with me, first of all, so you can see the differences in the two ways of being.
Yeah.
So I'm going to act out these lines, first of all, being a way that kind of stops me, so being anxious. And your job here is to really ham it up. Most people like me, if you're really reserved, you hate doing this, and that's part of the kind of breakthrough experience. So really practice acting this out, really ham it up, and don't worry what people are thinking about. So to be or not to be. That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer. Oh God! the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles.
You realise that his impact on people.
So to be or not to be, that is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against the sea of troubles and by opposing enemies. Great, so you're just going to step into two different ways of being, and the idea is just have a bit of fun with it. First of all, see how you're doing when you get stopped, but also practice actually stepping into something new for you. So what I'd like to do is pair up in pairs. If you don't quite work out as a pair, join up as a three. Find a bit of space in the room and set up. And your job is to act out those two ways of being and reading those lines. I know you've got your breakfast, but you have to leave your breakfast aside just for one moment. And then if you know Joseph and Ariel, and then Dinolo and Richard, Adam and Ken, and then we go around in pairs. And Omar, and
Tom, Just have a bit of fun with your public speaking and practicing, not kind of worrying so much about how you're coming across,
and just to be self-expressed with another person. Some people say, so is that a little bit like acting? I'm stepping into something that I wouldn't normally do. Is that like acting? Well, it is in a way, but what I would say is it's kind of authentic acting. You're stepping into something that actually you're saying, this is the person I want to be. It's the person that inspires you. So it is kind of authentic acting. And your job is then to actually enact that, not just in your public speaking, but in everything you're doing. The words that you've written down, ask yourself, how can I enact that in my business, in my life, in everything that I'm doing? And then what we've given you here is just a real kind of taster of that. And the reason we work over the long term for our leadership training, our public speaking, is that what you're doing is changing habits of a lifetime. The way on the left is actually easier to do because we're so used to it. It's actually more familiar to us. Stepping into something new is completely different. It's inspiring, but it takes practice to do that. It's a little bit like learning to drive. In that first test that you have when you're sitting down with the instructor, you get your hands on the steering wheel, you get a bit of control, and you get to experience driving a little bit. But it takes, you know, a good 3 to 6 months to actually rigorously train to practice that new way of being. And that's what I do in our public speaking course. I don't pretend to be a fully accomplished speaker, but I'm far enough in that journey to be able to coach other people in practicing new ways of being inspired. So that's Chris Hayes, Freedom Work UK. What I'm going to do is hand out details of some of the courses that we've got that. If you want to have a conversation with me about how to refer people to that, we can set up a one-on-one. So I'll cross that around. And I think that's going to be just on the bubble. So thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you.